I find say they wanna see her face.
Anita, Nelly, Suj, say hi.
Hanging out with today. Kasia, how far?
Hey!
What up?
Pali, how far?
The very beautiful Castoria 6 months. This lady is so adorable, no cap. Hey babies, and how are you all doing? Welcome back to Seo with Mimi Shostly Mimi, where you get the gist. Aside heart. Guys, before we dive into the gist at hand, do not forget to subscribe and make sure your notification bell is steadily on so you don't miss out on all of the juicy gist Mimiciously Mimi brings your way. Meanwhile, Big Brother Africa winner Karen is still pleading to see her kids. Yes, she's still on it. I hope she actually, you know, get due with this one. Save, most especially save, guys. Get why? Because having all of these deals with white people, it's funny sometimes. Okay, so talking about winner, it may seem as though it's drags day for the Big Brother winners, as Truth Icon chose today to drag Fina and Laycorn. As she says, still can't believe Laycorn and Fina were once BBN winners and millionaires. Just imagine with these pictures. I don't know where this person got these pictures of Laycorn and Fina from, and said, see, Osalobwa, see, waiting this one wear for her is just drags on Fina and Laycorn's day. Wahala be like bicycle. Meanwhile, reverse is the case for Ilebaye, as Ilebaye shared this poster, a movie called Ilebaye will be out on the 11th. So, Baye shared on her Snapchat, because that was where I saw it. She said, love this. They named the movie after my name, Ilebaye. Who knows what they want to add there anyways. Meanwhile, the fans of Ilebaye have been trending the movie just because of their fave name is there. You see, who knows if the people who produce this film know what they are doing. Now look at how Baye tribes are trending this for free. Just free trend, free PR. Let's read some of the reactions before we continue. You will have people celebrate you. You will have movie named after you, Ilebaye. When they name a whole movie after your fave, Ilebaye, the power you hold. You know, Jesus. So the fans are super duper happy that the film was named Ilebaye. Okay, guys, let's move straight back to the Big Brother No Lose Guard housemate. So yesterday, they actually went for it was brand visit day for them. They went to some of the sponsored brands of Big Brother No Lose Guard season. Yes, like they went to Indomie, Danone, Lopak, and all of that. So they went there. It was fun. And trust, sale with Mimiciously Mimi. Of course, I shared the video with you guys. I'm sure you saw it. If you did not see it, I posted that yesterday. Go back to my channel. It is sitting pretty right there, okay? Where your faves were displaying, most especially my babies, Wani X Handy. Oh, I'm not gonna lie, those babies, you see that energy? I think that's a perfect name for them. Like, they are so energetic. Anywhere they go, they fill the room with smiles, laughter. They are so bubbly. Meanwhile, there's some kind of, you know, shenanigans after their visits to the brands. There's some discovery. You know, we're going to be talking about them. But first off, let me start with the Castoria. Yeah, Victoria and Cassia, they were both present yesterday. So, Victoria shared this. This for Lupac. You know, they weren't together. She says, Cassia, why are you jumping? She shared this on her IG story tagging Cassia, and then Cassia shared on her own story and says, besties that wins together stay forever. Like, it's giving love. In fact, Cassia says, my second husband, that Victoria is her second husband. I think the love is so real here, and their fans, their lovers have been trending them. Okay, it's not official. Victoria is Cassia's second husband. Inject it or choke on it. Castoria, the standard. Victoria and Cassia, beautiful women with gifted hands and industrious mindset. Castoria run things up. Castoria yardstick of 6 months. They set standards way too high. Okay, let's read some more. Cute Nancy says, my highlight this season is that no matter how they edit Cassia and Victoria's picture, it's still no jig because they are too fine. Talking about that, because you know, people, I don't know fans, I don't know what is wrong with some of them. You know, what they do is, because of Cassia and Victoria was trending that yesterday, they started using their pictures to edit funny things with their picture. And it was where the brand asked a question they shared on their story. I mean, Dano, they shared on their story that face card that never declines. They said it's a yes or no. So naysayers went, I don't know how they dragged that pool where they said no, that meaning that their face card is not giving. I don't know how they edited that stuff for Cassia and Victoria, but it is what it is. The cocoa of the matter is, we all know that those two babies are so adorable. But honestly speaking, Stanship is doing a lot to some of you guys. I hope some of you all get to realize this on time. Meanwhile, still talking about some of the shenanigans that happened after the housemate visit, there is drag on Cassia. They were dragging Cassia because of Wani X Handy. Like I told you guys, Wani X Handy, they were displaying so much at the brand visits yesterday. You know how lively they can be. They were, you know, the way they can be dramatic. So they were doing all of that. And the camera who was videoing Wani X Handy, it was through Wani X Handy live that I was watching. Yes. So the person who was handling Wani's phone, live on IG, because I said Wani X Handy, it's not like they had to account together. It was just Wani's life. Wani was the one who went live on IG, you know, and then I was there watching. So the person who was handling Wani's phone showcased Cassia too and all of that. You know, when somebody is displaying in a funny way, like how dramatic they can be, I'm very sure sometimes you put out a face like, yeah, these girls, you know, that kind of a thing. Even me who enjoy them, sometimes my face would be like, you know, it's just like somebody is displaying something, your face is giving like that kind of display they are giving. That was how Cassia's face was. It wasn't an irritating face or anything, but guess what? Fans started dragging her. They started calling her that, look at how this one is looking at them, look, giving them evil eyes and all of that. And it was nothing close to that. I shared the video yesterday. That video was there too. Even Cassia's reactions to Wani X Handy display, it was nothing close to that. It was just facial expression of you watching people display. Like, I don't get how people do this, their drag of a thing. Did you watch that video yesterday? Do you think there's something wrong with how Cassia's face was? Let me know in the comment section. I would love to hear from you too, okay? All right, Reality Hot Take says, why is only one side of the table clapping for Kelly Ray? Apart from Anita, Abinelli and Suge get issue with Kelly Ray. That is the problem. That is the problem. You guys keep looking for issues every now and then with this housemate. The last time I checked, Nelly and Kelly Ray are guys. Like, they are really cool with each other, including Suj. So, in fact, you could notice, I don't know if you followed up the housemate like I do, but when you checked on them when they went visiting, they were so engrossed on their phones. They were all pressing their phones, like they were carried away with their phones. So it is normal for them not to concentrate. Not clapping does not mean they are not happy with Kelly Ray or whatever, but of course they had to also trend that one. The way people take things so deep with this housemate is so appalling, like really not cool at all. So Suge is the alpha male of the season, says Favor. Talking about Suge being the alpha male of the season, somebody says engage. Says engage if you see your spot your fave here. And then someone said down here, Kelly looks like the one that went out with 1% and Suge look like he won. You see this thing that you people do, right? You measure this housemate with how the dress, you talk down on how the dress and everything. It's really not cool at all, you know. So they are saying that Kelly Ray do not dress like a winner, that look at what he is putting on for brand visit, a winner for that matter, that should look unique more than others or whatever, that should look different from others. I'm like, you guys take this life so deep, and most of you all love fake life, I'm telling you. Okay, this person says, let's see some of the reactions. I will take the one with the actual money while you struggle with the looks. Is that your stand? Wahala. Why did you guys bring Sean pictures here? And then Hugh says, check Google, we will know who
worn, not by who dressed up, and it's on period. You prefer the packaging, you don't even care about what is inside the packaging. Okay, meanwhile, there is so much complaint. Let me read this. The only people I see outside are the finalists this season. Even the brand visit, only finalists are there. The other housemates don't call, which kind of season be this? Netizens are complaining because of the season yet again. Let me read this. You take the finalists for brand visit and then ignore the other housemates. This season is so stupid from production to the end. So someone says, so all 28 housemates should pack themselves and be going for brand visitor B, and then Hugh says level up was 28 and they all went. Why would they invite only finalists and their pairs for brand visits? What happened to other housemates? This is highly discrimination because you think they are not popular enough to be there. The way you guys sound though, this is the first season of Big Brother that almost 2 weeks after the show there hasn't been any brand visit. Or are the housemates not going to have brand visit this year? Or more, it just hurts for nobody looking for every reason that is not tangible to drag the production. You started off with when the season was on, it's boring, the production this, the production that. In fact, talking about the production, there was a whole space opened on what the production is doing wrong. I would share it with you guys. Yes, I was on that space. I recorded it. I will share with you guys because I would really love to hear your 2 cents. Too, okay, I will share it later on today with you guys so that you get to tell me what you think about what people said about the production, where they are lacking, and how they blame some of your faith to it. You're gonna hear all of that. Do not worry, I got you. Trust me, I'm always bringing it back to your doorstep, hence why you should be able to subscribe and then make sure your notification bell is steadily on. So yeah, they are complaining, guys. They said that the housemates who went for the brand visit were few, that it was supposed to be all of the housemates. It was just only the final 8 that were there. But do not forget, OC was there, Chizoba was there. They are not among the final 8. Even Cassia was there too, you know. So I do not think they invited just few of the housemates who are quite popular. No ways, you know. I think it's a thing of choice, or maybe you never can tell. I don't know. I just don't know what happened. Maybe those people, other ones, could not make it. But I do not think the brand decided to select few, because if you notice, they shared the picture of all of the housemates. But it is what it is. I don't know what might have gone wrong, you know. But you guys should just take it easy on the production. Any which ways, guys, me, I'm going to be dropping my voice right here and now to see you guys later. Thank you so much for always sailing with me. Bye for now, babies.